was a very interesting moment, as I was explaining yesterday also, that this is how the whole combination came into mind.
Mm-hmm.
That when the bishop was on c5, I was kind of thinking, imagine if my rook was on g1 in this position, mm-hmm. hypothetically.
Okay.
Then I would play knight f6 check,
okay.
king h8,
okay.
and queen h6.
Wow, yes. So let me see if there is a null move possibility.
Or just play rook g1 and then, you know, just play rook b8 or something. Yeah,
yeah, any random
idea.
Yeah,
just
like
make
this.
Any random move.
And now this is the idea. So you play knight check, king h8, and queen h6. Wow, this
queen
is a beautiful
h6.
Position.
Yeah.
This is
so. Amazing. So then I saw I could also play right now knight f6 check, even without this rook on g1.
Okay.
Okay, he cannot take gf6 because I have queen h6 and there is this e6 bishop is hanging.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll play knight f6, he'll play king h8.
Yes.
And then I can play queen g5.
Okay.
But I thought this gives him some additional options here and there.
Mm-hmm.
And if I can start with queen g5 first, why not to start with queen g5? I can keep this in hand, yeah?
Yeah.
So I played,
mm-hmm. yep.
so I played queen g5.
Pawn h6, he's attacking.
Pawn h6 is also the most natural move. Yeah, what else?
Yeah, looks obvious. But like they say, don't play on the side where you're weak. That comes to my mind. So I'm not sure if that is the best move. Or maybe it is the only move.
Well, basically I'm threatening, let's say, just I'm threatening g8-7 check otherwise. And after king h8, rook dg1. I mean, there will be million ways to mate there.
Yeah, there's no defender.
Yeah, and as white, you would like to take care of h6 because after h6, it's kind of gets everything gets blocked. Yeah.
Yeah.
So h6 for me, the most natural way is to play knight f6. Okay, gf7 is also standard.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, once you see knight f6 check, king h8, somewhere you think like, okay, this hg5 will not work.
Yeah, because of this rook aligned on the h line.
Yeah. So my original idea, like the first calculation was after h6, knight f6, king h8, I wanted to take bishop into e6,
mm-hmm.
f into e6,
mm-hmm.
and now rook d7, threatening queen h6, threatening
queen
h6.
Queen h6, g8, and mate.
Yeah, but rook f6 kind of, kills
the
line. Only move, probably one of the only move, maybe bishop e7 also works. But yeah, rook f6.
So
then I saw, I can play rook dg1.
Directly.
And here, first of all, I'm threatening queen takes h6.
Yeah.
So there is only one move, hg5. In the game, he blundered, he played fg6. I think he missed that after queen g6, both queen h7 and queen g7 is threatened.
Checking, yeah.
So hg5 was forced.
Okay.
And I take h into g5.
Mm-hmm.
Now again, gf6 is forced because otherwise I just give a discovered check and it's mate.
Correct. Okay.
So gf6, I take g into f6.
Very cool move. Just as if nothing has happened. You lost the queen. But yeah, gf6 then.
Yeah. So yeah, I'm like right now a queen down and a bishop down. But okay. A game of chess is basically, you know, who mates first.
Correct. Yeah.
So now again, king g8 is forced because after fg6, it's important that bishop e6 is direct mate.
Yeah, king has no square.
So king g8, and now I play g7.
Okay.
So this was the line that I mainly considered
during the game.
Like this was the first position that was kind of important.
Mm-hmm.
And now my thought process were exactly as follows. So I saw, I was mostly concerned about knight e7.
Knight e7 when?
After g7.
So you're concerned about knight e7. Okay.
And knight e7, because okay, you want to get your knight to g6.
Mm-hmm.
So I had bishop into e6, stopping knight g6 because knight g6, there is now rook g6. Mm. So f into e6.
So, one moment. G7, knight e7, bishop into e6, f into e6.
Yeah.
Okay.
And now knight e5.
Oh, taking away the f7 square from the king.
And there is nothing you can do about rook h8, mate.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, it's mate.
So, Then, and in when I played g7, I saw there is b3 and c3, but both doesn't make sense because, okay, after c3, I can simply take on e6.
When c3?
Let's say after g7, yeah?
After g7, then c3, yeah, a2 is hanging.
Take. Now, there were many ways to win the game. Easiest was, I think, you take gf8 queen, king f8 and rook g7.
Threatening rook h8 mate.
And there is nothing you can do about it.
Yeah.
And likewise, I briefly saw there is b3.
Mm-hmm.
But I have cb3, cb3, a3.
And bishop into a3 is not working because...
Just bishop moves and mate.
Yeah, bishop moves and
mate. Then... something weird happened. Actually, this is a very interesting story. I did not share it so far anywhere else.
Okay.
So after CB3, apparently black can play knight B4.
After CB3, knight B4. Oh, okay.
Okay, so I actually briefly saw knight B4, but I saw A3 and during the game, I saw A3 and I didn't see anything else.
Mm-hmm.
But after my game finished,
mm-hmm.
I quickly checked with chess.com engine.
Mm-hmm.
I saw it is showing winning for black.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't trust it. Mm-hmm. I checked with my own engine.
Mm-hmm.
And then also some remote engine.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw initially it started saying, that black is winning. But then they changed.
Okay.
And it gave the following variation.
Mm-hmm.
Queen d8 after a3.
Okay.
This is the move that I missed.
Mm-hmm.
Threatening both queen d3 and queen f6.
Okay.
Knight into e5. Stopping queen d3.
Yeah.
Queen f6.
Queen f6. Okay. Knight is attacked.
Bishop into e6. Bishop. Threatening mate again.
Again, rook h8 is threatened.
So, queen g7 only move.
Yes.
Rook takes g7. King takes g7. Bishop c8.
Rook takes c8.
Rook c8. And let's say now rook g1 check and a into b4, winning hands down.
Wow.
So I saw this quickly on my engine and also with ChessBase remote engine.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was in ChessBase India stream.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I told the same thing what I said here. Like I missed queen d8. I saw, b3, I can simply play cb3 and a3.
Mm-hmm.
But, the strong engines are saying this is winning and so on.
Okay.
And today morning, I saw Sagar published a video, a small video just on this this game.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw Nisha Mohta,
mm-hmm.
my colleague and, from my city.
Mm-hmm.
She commented that what is wrong with, I'll tell you the move number. What is wrong with 20 in this variation after b3?
Mm-hmm.
What is wrong with bishop f5?
28th move?
25th move after b3.
Just
bishop f5.
But queen a2, is it not dangerous? Looks very scary to me.
So the thing is, okay, when I checked today morning with my engine,
mm-hmm.
my local engine gave after b3, it said cb3 wins plus 5. Mm-hmm. Any other move is minus 9 for black.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, when I saw this Nisha's comment,
bishop f5,
yeah, and she gave some variation which I will show now, I thought, okay, she must be, she must have missed something. Let me just calculate and figure it out.
Okay,
what it is.
Okay.
And I could not see.
Oh.
I tried every time I'm seeing it, it's like mate. Then I was like, wait, but I did check with some very strong engines. And so what went wrong? So again, I opened my laptop, got to the position, kept bishop f5.
Okay.
And got the best possible engine, remote engine, both Stockfish 12, Lila and everything. So, and then only after a certain point, at around depth 30 or something, mm-hmm. it says mate in 15.
Mate in 15. Wow. Oh.
The thing is, then I regretted that why did I even check the engine? Because if I would not check engine... bishop f5 is what the move you want to calculate first, not bishop e6, because bishop e6 gives an additional square. So now if you make the most logical moves, yeah, after bishop f5, black has to give some checkmate, otherwise he's mated.
Correct.
So which means queen a2 is forced.
Correct. King c1.
You play king c1, queen a1 check is forced.
King d2.
You play king d2. Now, okay, if you play rook d8 check,
rook f.
You simply go, yeah, rook f d8 check, you simply go king e2, and then there are no checks.
Oh.
So I thought after king d2, the point is c3, and this is what Nisha must have missed.
Mm-hmm.
Because now after bc3,
mm-hmm.
now there is rook f d8 check, and king e2, there is bishop c4 mate.
Oh, wow, that's a clearance.
But then I saw Nisha actually gave this exact variation. And after rook f d8 check, there is knight d4.
After rook f d8 check, in the variation, you mean with c3?
Yeah, yeah, c3.
Bc3. Rook f d8, there is knight d4 interposing.
Wow.
Yes, and now knight d4, rook takes d4, and now king e2.
Not cd4, because it brings the queen back to d4, so king e2.
Yeah, bishop c4 check, king e3. The king simply
e3
runs.
Or f3?
King f3, king f3,
okay,
sorry.
King f3. Okay.
You can give rook d3 check, I'll take that also. You can give knight d4 check, I'll take that also.
Wow, this is...
You can give queen d1 check, I'll take that also. So, on the king f3 position,
mm-hmm.
White is one queen, one bishop and one knight down.
Wow.
It doesn't matter.
It actually doesn't matter.
Wow, this is beautiful.
What a game.
All right, let's address quickly what Arjun is saying. Arjun Erigais is saying c3, bishop e6, f e6.
Yeah, I think Niranjan, that's a long way back.
When?
After, I think, instead of queen d8.
Ah,
okay.
Yeah. No, but that did not work. Yeah, I will take rook f8 and knight g5. Yeah, we should have addressed this, by the way.
So you're saying not queen d8, but...
C3.
Knight b4, a3, but, that variation.
No. 25th move, c3.
25th move, c3. Yes, I got 25th move, c3.
Yeah, keep going.
Bishop into e6.
Rook
g6.
Yeah, fe6, F-E-6. Gf8, queen, king f8,
rook g7,
rook g7. King e8, okay. Rook h8,
bishop f8,
and bishop f8, and take bishop f8.
Take rook takes f8, you mean?
Take rook takes f8, yeah.
King takes f8?
Knight g5.
Oh my god.
This you saw in the game.
Yeah.
Wow.
Brilliant.
Knight e6 is coming and then...
Yeah.
Beautiful. So will you consider this as one of your best games of 2020?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, two games that I can compare with similar theme was my game against Spoilman and also my game against Abhijit Kunte from some Asian championship. Uh-huh. Very similar theme, especially this knight g5 is very similar to my game against Spoilman in Vikansi.
Okay, I have to take a look at that game and the Kunte game as well.
Kunte game is very similar to where I was launching on kingside attack.
Okay.